Hey guys, I'm here at Mad Decent Block Party Cuthbert Amphitheater. Dylan Francis just got here. How long have you been in Eugene? Not very long.
Since 2 o'clock.
I didn't even really need to ask that because I follow you on Snapchat, so I knew I pretty
right
much
when I
knew when you got
where
here.
Where I landed.
Is this your first time in Eugene?
What my hotel room number was. No, this is 5th time? 6th time?
Wow. Do you like Oregon? Do you like returning to Oregon?
I do. I like it a lot.
College towns have got to be fun, though.
Yeah, they're fun, but they're, like, a bit boring.
Really?
Just because there's not a lot going on. Because, like, I can't go to college. I mean,
true.
I can, but...
But there's, like college-y stuff. Do you ever go to after parties after the college shows or anything like that?
No. Usually have to go to another show or, like, go to sleep for an early flight.
Yeah, that makes sense. The traveling has got to be, like, one of the hardest things.
Now it's definitely taking a toll. Like, where you gotta really, like... pick your poison on which day and then sleep a lot more and just try to, like, because with this touring schedule, I've been so bad at making music.
Really?
Yeah.
Just because it's been so fast-paced, you just don't have the time?
Yeah, I don't have time to, like, really, sit down and focus on something a lot. So it's like, I have a new single coming out on September 16th, but I haven't made anything.
Is it the one with Party Favor, or that's
no.
music video coming out?
Yeah, that's a music video. We already put that song out.
On the EP. But the music video is coming out. I just talked to him a little bit ago, so I got with that.
Yeah, we did that last night.
Yeah, and he said it was fun.
It was. We got to work with the dude from Starship Troopers.
Really?
Cameron Bandine? Yeah. And he was on it, and then the director was a guy that he's like the main stunt person in Hollywood, and I think he's been in a bunch of movies. He also got shot in the eye. I don't know if that was movie related or just you know, gang gun violence related.
So we can expect stunts in this music video
crazy
stunts.
He didn't say anything about that?
No, he mentioned
okay, I'm not
no
gonna say
stunts.
Anything. Wow, so I'm fucking it up.
Spoiler alert.
That's his, he should have said that. I mean, it's probably on his Snapchat, so, you know.
Wasn't on your Snapchat.
No,
because
I
don't. Because
it's his music video.
You feel the right to Snapchat it.
No, it's his.
Speaking of your Snapchat, so my friend Evergreen over here, she opened the show tonight. She actually turned me on your Snapchat week ago. And now I have to say, after following you on Snapchat and seeing the hilarity daily, I definitely think you belong to host SNL.
I would love that so much.
Really? I didn't know. No, I'm kidding. You have, like, a big campaign going on Twitter, but, like, a lot of people are behind you on it. It's kind of cool.
I know. It's really awesome. The
like,
amount
even
of
your label. I was like, whoa, Sony's posting about this?
Well, of course Sony's posting this. Then they're going to play my music on it, and they're going to make money from it. But of course they would get behind because, you know, I mean, hopefully they like me as a person and want me on their label. But
no, don't put him on SNL.
But, yeah, no, it was cool to, like, I didn't try to make it a campaign, but I just wanted to see if people would be down, and, like, the amount of people that were actually into it was really cool. Yeah.
Do you have, like, any big sketch ideas you wanna put out on SNL? Do you have ideas working already?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
No more spoiler alerts, though.
No.
More spoilers.
I wouldn't want to say it.
We just have to wait and find out.
Yeah.
Do you have, like, a favorite SNL sketch of all time?
Yes. Anything with Will Ferrell or Chris Kattan.
Okay.
They were my favorites.
I feel like everyone picked that band down by the river one. That's Chris, right?
Wait, close.
Is
sorry.
It?
Okay.
Maybe I'm wrong.
No, my favorite one is, like, I believe it was Chris Kattan in these, but where it was them working in, like, a fashion boutique, and anyone that would come in, they would just be, like, just talk so much shit to them.
Yeah, it's coming,
like,
back to me.
Yeah, and they'd have turtlenecks on, and then Will Ferrell comes in one where he's got a scooter, and then he's, like, on his small phone, and he talks in a monotone voice. He's like, gotta go to the party now. And then, like, tries to get out, and he can't get out. And that actually, I don't think they planned it, so everyone's laughing on set. My favorite when people are laughing on set, because then it just makes everyone else laugh.
Mm-hmm. I feel like they always throw in those, like, spontaneous moments. You're like, I know that wasn't scripted.
Yeah.
Do you have a favorite cast member of all time?
Right now? Or from...
Both. Current season and of all time. Why not?
Of all time, man, I think, well, it used to be Will Ferrell, and I think Andy Samberg is, like, second runner-up, but he's not on anymore, and then for now, it would probably be Kyle, or...
Really?
Yeah.
That kind of surprises me. Is that
or
bad?
The other guy that's his friend that does, they were...
Pete, I think? Are you talking...
Pete Davidson's amazing. Actually, I really like Pete Davidson, because he's so funny.
He is funny.
But there's that other guy that's... Friends with Kyle named Digits gets together.
They play the friends that are like super awkward.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
That guy. I think that guy's my favorite because he gets better parts than Kyle does. I think he does
better
right now.
They're not very many skits, really.
They're not.
Those guys up.
They do.
They really feature the same people over and over.
Yeah.
So I'm looking around. I don't see someone that I expected to see, which is someone named Gerald. Is he hiding?
He's at my house.
You
I don't travel
behind?
With him. No.
He's probably fragile to travel with.
Yeah, he'd probably break.
All of my listeners who found out I was interviewing you, they were like, Gerald, the only thing I want you to talk about is Gerald. And apparently he got like a skin color change or something recently. Like
yeah,
he had
he
in his hair color.
He got resurrected and he's been trying to kill me. He transforms at night into this like black demon creature.
I saw that.
So
he's there 1 minute, gone another.
Yeah, I'm trying to figure out what to do and how to handle it. But I travel so much that you know.
He just wreaks havoc when you're gone.
Yeah, probably. I mean, he's probably masturbating on my pillow. Right?
him and Hansel will team up together.
They're probably going to
bring you down.
Yeah.
I have to admit, I kind of wish Hansel was here as well because I really need to work on my German accent. I just feel like he's the ideal candidate.
Do you need to work on your German or a German accent?
Yes, both.
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 Okay.
And I feel like he'd be the guy, yeah?
He would. Probably.
Are you good at a German accent by chance?
No.
I didn't think so. So I know, I'm sure this summer has been crazy because every summer festival season and stuff. What has been like your number one show for the past like 3 months? Like what's your favorite one?
My favorite one, it might be the one that we did in, that I'm talking about Tormentor now when I say we.
Okay.
I like to, because I look at him all the time. But,
just look to that smiling face and remember.
I was playing in Norway and our videographer/photographer was like, yeah, play Barbie Girl. Like, it's from here. It's not from there. You know that? I looked it up.
Aqua's not
from there?
Is it from
Denmark?
No. They're from Denmark.
Oh.
So it's not Norway at all, which he said they were from Norway.
Yeah.
And so
come on.
But they did like it. So I did a mashup with my song Set Me Free.
Ooh.
And it worked well, but I also fucked up the mashup because I left the reverb on in Ableton for the thing that I was doing. And yeah, so that was definitely the best one because they were singing along. So it was fine, but it was definitely like.
So even though it wasn't like perfect, still the best one.
Yeah.
I like that though.
It was really fun. Then the whole crowd was just insane.
Is it different going to different countries? Do you notice any? Are the crowds kind of all the same vibe, or is there any difference?
No, it's totally
country
different.
Country?
Like, I mean, yeah.
Keep going.
Oh, cool.
Last one.
The main thing is like clothing. Like, if you go to the UK, like everyone's dressed in top man. If you go to a festival in America, everyone is wearing, like, Wookiee costumes and, like, massive moon boots on. Not making fun of it, I'm just saying it's different.
That's awesome, though. Okay, last thing. We got to wrap it up here because I know you're literally going to hop on stage
yes.
now. I have to talk about this shirt real quick because I talked about it to you before we got on this. So right now you have an In Memory of Taylor Swift 1989
yep.
to 2016 shirt. Yes. So I'm just going to go ahead and assume Team Kimye.
Well, my friends
Honorable
made this.
Drama.
My friends made this T-shirt, Pizza Slime. They got to discontinue, or what is it? No, they got to cease and desist. Yeah. They got to discontinue. They got to cease and desist from someone from Taylor.
TAS management.
Yeah, probably.
Shut down from Taylor though. That's kind of cool.
They got shut down. So it's just
this is rare.
In memory of. To cease and desist.
It's awesome. I love it. Well, thank you so much for taking the time out. I know you're hella busy.
You.
You're about to hop on stage.
Yeah.
I can't wait to see you for the first time. I'm really excited.
It's going to be amazing.
Yeah.
I don't Snapchat during that show, so that's the only bummer.
I'll do it for you. I got it.
Okay.
Personal Snapchat. All right. Thanks, Dylan.
Thank you. Appreciate it.